Hello guys and welcome. Today I will show you how to make a hoglins farm, and it's actually a very simple farm. Like, there are a lot of very complicated hoglins farms out there, especially on YouTube, and today I'm going to show you how to make a way more simple one, and one that is also beginner friendly. So let me show you what I came up with. So this is my hoglin farm. It's with a double fence, and I'll later explain you why you need a double fence. Because not only does it protect you from taking damage, it also keeps the hoglins safe from piglins that could attack, because they raid from time to time. And if you're standing there, you don't take any damage, because the double fence protects you. And oh wow, are those many hoglins. So let me show you how it works. So let me get on survival so I can take damage and I can show you. So yeah, they get all triggered, and if I'm like 3 blocks from them, because their range is 2 blocks, they can't harm me. However, if I'm at the edge of the 3rd block, I can harm them. You guys see that? And we can actually obtain the meat and the leather. Let me show you how. So I dug this whole area out there, and there's like a trapdoor. And why is there so much trapdoor? Because if you jump against the trapdoor, you can actually get what's on top of that trapdoor, and you don't even need to open it. So we just obtained now some meat and leather without taking any damage thanks to that trapdoor. Ouch, okay, this was too close. Be careful to not get too close. You always need to stay 3 blocks away from them. If you get too close by 2 blocks, for example, they will harm you. And yeah, make sure to hit them from 3 blocks, like here. And you can repeat this process as often as you like, but make sure you still have some hoglins left, because you don't want to take out all of them, right? Because then you have to catch them again. And catching those hoglins and getting them in there can be a little tricky. And you can also breed them here. Let me quickly show you. That's how you breed them. You can also breed them from a distance of 3 blocks, because that's the player's reach. The player's reach is 1 block further than the hoglin, so this is why I didn't take damage when I was like hitting them. And if you breed them, you also get XP, and you can breed them if you open the trapdoors if you wanted to. But be careful, the baby hoglins can fall through. Like, this happens sometimes, especially if they get pushed by the adult ones. And yeah, oh, there's some XP I just saw. And wait, yeah, I need to grab that XP, one moment. Okay, we got all the XP, I think. Yeah, there's nothing left. Okay, let me show you now how to make this one from scratch. It's quite easy. You just need a lot of wood, unfortunately, so you need to cut down a couple of crimson trees. But hey, farming wood is very fast and easy. So yeah, let's first put a fence down here. It's better if you go for a bigger area, by the way, because if you have like a huge population of hoglins, this is way better. Because then you don't need to worry about like slaughtering some, because you're still gonna have some left, right? So in this example, I'll go for a way bigger farm than the first one. And then again, it also depends on how often and how much food you need. But bigger is better, trust me, because it's quite difficult to set this up at the beginning. Once you have set it up, it's actually quite easy and it's very automatic. And yeah, hoglins can move 2 blocks. So I mean, they need a space of 2 blocks, and that's the only way they can move through. And be careful with those piglins, they can attack, so you always need a double fence. Excuse me. So yeah, now it's done. We have here 1 space left, and here 2 spaces. Let me show you why 2 spaces on this side, because we still need to catch those hoglins, right? So in a moment I will switch back to survival and I will trap 2 hoglins in there. So yeah, let's keep 2 blocks opened here so a hoglin can fit through. And let's get rid of this. Wait, oh, that's just 1 block. Oh, okay, I need to... Yeah, it must be 2 blocks. One moment. Okay, now we have 2 blocks. So now we can trap one if we wanted to. So let me switch to survival. Let's trigger one. Okay, this one's triggered. Ouch! Okay, I didn't want that. Now we run through this 1 block space where the hoglin can't move through, because they can only move through 2 spaces. Like 2 block spaces. Let's close this up before any piglin attacks, because we don't want to lose this one. And we're gonna get a second one as well. So now we have two hoglins. I trapped them both inside through survival. And let's close this up. And let me show you a mistake that you shouldn't make. And that's... You shouldn't make the gate on the side. I'll quickly show you why not. But let me build this first. And let me get also... Oh yeah, the trapdoor. I need to put the trapdoor down. It's very important. Because otherwise... I could lose them through the piglins. Because there's an issue with piglins. They sometimes like will hunt down hoglins. So if they see those hoglins here. And there's like no trapdoor or anything. And it's just one block high. They could actually use their crossbow to shoot them. And you don't want that, right? Anyway, let's get more hoglins. And let me show you that this farm can fully function. And it's very simple. And yeah, let me show you. Okay, I think that's about enough. And now let me show you that mistake that you don't want to make and why you don't want to. Oh, I forgot the trapdoors. Yeah, let me quickly get the trapdoors there because we need them so we can collect the stuff, the meat and the leather. All right, let's place them. I should have placed those before. It's better actually if you have them early on before you get those hoglins. So this was like a little mistake I did. I'm sorry about that. But it's okay. Because they cannot fall through. Even if there's like one block of space. They can't fall through one block spaces. They need more than that. Because they are so huge and fat. They're like monster pigs, right? And monster pigs, they don't fit through one block. That's why they need two blocks to move through. Alright, let's patch this up. Because the way the nether biomes are generating, it's very strange. We have a lot of floating islands and stuff, so... Oh, wait. Oh yeah, I still need their fence. A trapdoor, sorry. Okay, it's all set. Let's patch this up, that looks ugly. And now let me show you why you shouldn't have the door on the side. So now, they will not attack me. I mean, they will try to attack me, but they will come from the side here. Okay, I was too close. You see, it's very difficult to reach them that way. So let's change this. Let's make it here on the front. So yeah, be very careful when you build this to not make it on the side. Make it to the front, like the front entrance. Okay, nice. I need to clear a bit here. Alright. What I also do sometimes is I mark the location. Because this helps me to know, okay, this is 3 blocks. So, if you're like not familiar with the distance or how many blocks, make sure to place down even like cobblestone or any different block. It can also be basalt at the 3rd block from the gate so you know the distance. I hope I can get through unharmed. Okay, I didn't take any damage. Good. I need to clear the area a bit more. Okay, and we are getting now XP, we're getting some meat, some leather, what is really, really nice. And as you guys can see, we didn't take any damage. So it's pretty safe. And even if you get hit like 1 or 2 times, you're getting so much food that you can easily heal back up. So don't worry about that. But make sure the area is clear so you really have always at least 3 blocks of a distance. And you can breed them again as well. Like try to breed them as much as you can and keep the population high. Only slaughter them and get the stuff when you know there are like still a lot of those left. Okay, let's get some more. We have a low population so I probably need to spawn some after this. But I just wanted to show you that guys, so that's why I didn't wait. And I was too close. Be careful, always try to keep a 3 blocks distance. Okay. Let's go back under the trapdoors and let's get the good stuff. Alright. We have so much meat now, even though if we get hit 1 or 2 times, there's no problem. We immediately heal back up. Oh yeah. I shouldn't have done this too early. I should have bred them more. Let's spawn some more. So be very careful to have always a high population. At least 8. And yeah, those piglins, they are trouble. So always double fence this so they can't reach them. That's how you set this thing up. It's very simple. It's beginners friendly. And if you are like starting in the nether, you can also do this. You don't need redstone or anything. I hope this guide was useful for you, this tutorial. And if you guys are new to the channel, please don't forget to subscribe. And I wish everyone a wonderful day. Until next time.